This is the third part in a series of three parts that Bach on the Clock decided to focus on this wonderful instrument here, the harpsichord, which, in my estimation, is probably Bach's favorite keyboard instrument, although we know that he played clavichord as well as the organ. But in public, when Bach was running rehearsals, this was the instrument he would come to. And we know that he wrote a great deal of keyboard music for himself, that from a variety of clues that we have, he probably preferred to play them on the harpsichord. When I was given the task, or asked by the board members of BATC to design a program featuring the harpsichord, you might be wondering why there are no solo harpsichord works on this concert. If you want to feature this instrument, shouldn't we be playing English suites and well tempered clavier and all this wonderful music for solo harpsichord? Most of the evidence that we have from the Baroque period historically never mentions the harpsichord as a solo instrument at all. In fact, the instrument builders at the time were only concerned with how the instrument sounded in a group. Orchestral playing, chamber music playing, and specifically continuo playing, which is the art of improvisation on the harpsichord with other instruments. But I wanted to have a little bit of a smattering of some music in here that really does feature the harpsichord as a solo instrument in some capacity. So we're going to start with the Flute Sonata in C major, which is an example of continuo harpsichord playing. So I'll be playing mostly improvised music, although in the final minuets there are some obbligato melodic harpsichord lines that Bach writes out. Just so you know, those minuets, they sort of form an ABA form. So there's a C major minuet, the minuet 2 is an A minor, and then it returns to C major minuet, and then the piece ends. It's sort of a fake ending. It's a bizarre ending to the Flute Sonata, but it's an absolutely charming piece. After that, I have two sonatas, one for violin and one for viola da gamba, both with obbligato harpsichord parts. This is non-improvisatory. Every note that I'm playing in those two pieces is written out. And really, the harpsichord and the solo instrument are truly an equal partnership. There really is not a dominant voice in those pieces. And the magic of the harpsichord, and really the historical instruments, is that nothing ever occupies the same sound world. So while the violin, with its brilliance and its sustain, because of the immediacy and the brilliance of the pluck of the harpsichord, they can both occupy the same pitches sometimes, and you can really clearly identify both lines happening through the whole piece. So the obbligato sonata for violin and harpsichord and viola da gamba in D major are absolute masterworks of Bach, and really kind of does show what this instrument is capable of. And finally, the trio sonata we're closing with is actually an organ sonata that is often played as a trio sonata. These were often interchangeable in Bach's time, so we're going to close with this wonderful C major Allegro, sort of in a bit of a thicker orchestral style, I think. Has sort of a similar groove to a lot of his Brandenburg Concerti and whatnot. So this has been a great pleasure of mine. I'm joined by some wonderful artists, and I just feel so privileged to be here and to share this event with you. So thank you very much. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.